The government's gymnastics on the issue of privatisation cannot mask the reality that with the establishment of Irish Water and the establishment of a charging regime, privatisation has already started. Your assurances are completely worthless. Look at the reality of Irish Water. 500 million to mostly to Dennis O'Brien GM Sierra to put in the meters. 175 million will be spent by the end of 2015 on consultants and private contractors. Landlords are now to be, private landlords are now to be the debt collectors for Irish Water. So effectively, already, Irish Water is the property of the consultants, the big contractors, and even private landlords acting as their agents. So already it is being privatised. But one of the most shocking aspects of Irish Water, which still has not fully been taken up in the general discussion about what's going on with Irish Water, but which really should ring the alarm bells in a very major way for what is going on with Irish Water. I'm just reading off the Irish Water's customer terms and conditions agreement. And this is what it says. The customer shall not allow the discharge of rainwater runoff from roofs, paved areas or other surfaces into any sewer, except as may otherwise be agreed in advance with Irish Water in writing. Now, what that is the legal basis for Irish Water to claim ownership over the rain that comes from the sky onto people's roofs. In Bolivia and in the United States, once private companies entered into the picture and the water services were within a legal entity that was a private entity, which Irish Water is, according to the Water Services Act, they claimed ownership over the rainwater and had inspectors going around to people's houses telling them that the water off their roof was the property and had to be paid for to the private company. This condition sets up the legal basis. Read it. I bet you haven't even
read it. Thank you, Deputy Day.
So that's what you're up to, and the people won't buy it. Deputy Day.